I want you to start by introducing yourself.
Yeah, my name is Alhaji. I am Sierra Leonean and I belong to the Sierra Leone Australian Community of Victoria, a not-for-profit community organization that is working towards helping families and community members that have migrated here in Australia from Africa.
And what is your role in the community?
My role, well, I was the former president. I just conducted elections and decided to step down because my time of office has ended. And I've worked with a lot of people across the board. I've worked with men, women, youth, and children. And we are here to help our community members, especially people who have migrated here with families and that have children.
Yeah, we're here to give them that support because
we know Australia is a multicultural country, but our families have come here and most of them are lacking, you know, in terms of schools and trying to integrate. So there are a lot of challenges here, you know, in regards to settlement.
Okay, apart from you being the past president of the Sierra Leone community, I know that you are a parent and you have a teenage daughter. What are some of the difficulties you think you are facing as an African and other African parents are facing? I'm very much sure that you have worked in this area for quite a long time. What are some of the difficulties you think parents are facing?
That is exactly the reason, one of the reasons, one of the strongest reasons, if I can say, that the organization is formed, because we know parents are going through difficulties in terms of trying to raise their young families here. So some of the difficulties we face are issues like peer pressures, because when our children come here, people from African background, we've seen children who, you know, now go to school and have the opportunity to meet with other Australian children, because their parents, you know, to say are illiterate or semi-illiterate, you know, they take advantage of that and they think, you know, they know better and they can do things on their own. And most of the times, these children will do things, you know, inappropriately, and they will become victims of crime, drugs, alcohol. There are a lot of issues in the community, but the community is here. The organization was formed in order to combat some of these issues in the community. And having a teenage child is challenging, yeah, in a lot of areas, because we want to give them the best. We want them to be, you know, good citizens of this country. We don't want to come here, you know, and become bad people, and for them to be influenced by bad people. Yeah,
with Clay Foundation, I'm very sure you have met Clay Foundation before and they are working with your child. What are some of the things you have seen that this project can be able to help in terms of reconnecting parents and their children and trying to balance communication between parents and children? What are the roles that Clay Foundation has actually played that you have identified?
Well, Clay Foundation has played a very vital role in trying to address the issues, challenging issues with parents and their teenage children. We know these children, you know, to be very difficult, and it's a very great big task in order to control them and to make them better people in society. But with the help of Clay Foundation that has come around, you know, we are really happy, because sometimes the children will not listen from people from their own background. They prefer to listen from people from different, you know, organizations that will give them that support. And Clay Foundation has played a very vital role, you know, to bridge that gap, you know, to create effective communication between children and their parents. They've also helped in a lot of ways, helping children to understand, you know, the issues regarding drugs, alcohol, and help them or prevent them from, you know, becoming crime victims.
So for now, Clay Foundation is not funded by the government. Everything that we are doing, we are all doing by ourselves. What will be your recommendation to the government in terms of Clay Foundation? How do you think the government can help?
Oh, well, I think it's a very important question that you have asked, and I will strongly, you know, advocate on behalf of Clay Foundation that they need the required resources, they need the required support in order to be able to do what they are doing, the good job that they are doing. You know, we are very much happy that this foundation, Clay Foundation, is around, you know, helping families and children, you know, and they need a lot of support in terms of resources. They need a lot of support in terms of like office space, stationery, transport. Yeah, they're doing a fantastic job because I remember they've organized a lot of events and activities, taking our children out and helping them, you know, teaching them and making them feel like part of the society and to make them feel important and to connect more with their parents.
And do you think that Clay Foundation has the expertise or the resources to be able to tackle cultural issue from an African perspective?
Yes, from my own point of view, I can recommend Clay Foundation to say they have the expertise, you know, in order to handle issues relating to African communities and families. Yeah, because they've really done a good job, and like I said earlier, they organizing a lot of activities and events and have mentors that are helping teenagers to understand and to communicate effectively with their parents and to be good role models, you know, in school, and yeah, also helping them to go further. Yeah, like an example can be my daughter telling me that Clay Foundation is helping us and is trying to not only to finish high school and think that you are, you know, you have finished school, but also to, you know, think ahead and to go to uni and to, you know, become qualified, you know, or trained personnel and to tap from, you know, the rich culture of Australia and to also think about helping people, you know, back home. And these are some of the messages that Clay Foundation is giving to these young people. And some of our parents, you know, sometimes just think their children should stay home and they don't, you know, try to give them the right advice and to make them move forward. Or even if they do, sometimes the children will not even listen to their parents and think, you know, now that they are here and the laws are protecting them and there are a lot of other, you know, supports around them, so they can do anything. So with coming of the Clear Foundation into our communities, programs and family programs, we are really grateful that they are doing a good job and we thank them for that.
Thank you very much.